what about, I suppose, more creative forms of UGC, images and that sort of thing? Anybody have any experience with that?
So at All Saints, we launched our first user-generated content campaign back in May last year. So our spring 2016 collection was entitled It's Up To You, and it was all about how All Saints isn't necessarily trend-led. It's more kind of giving you the ingredients to show off your own personal style. So It's Up To You obviously lent itself perfectly to user-generated content. So it was a direct call to action to show the way that you wear All Saints. So it wasn't restricted to that specific campaign. It could be an item that you'd had in your wardrobe for absolute years and you really treasured. We'd still celebrate that just the same. So we launched that May last year. We supported that with paid media outreach as well, repurposing the user-generated content through our own social channels, both organically and paid. We did an influencer outreach in order to kind of kickstart the activation, both to spread the awareness of the campaign, but also to guarantee really on-brand content to go live with. Mm-hmm. On that same vein, we actually soft launched it internally. So we spread the word to all of our store staff, first of all, because they're such amazing brand advocates. You know, they live, eat, dress, everything All Saints. So what better place to start it than with them? It also meant that they were completely ingrained with the campaign from the onset. So they felt really passionate talking to staff in our stores about it. So it was a really successful campaign, and since then we've actually integrated it into our social and overall comms strategy as a kind of always on scheme. So we have an evergreen UGC gallery. We now have user generated content on our product page, and we're looking to get that on the homepage as well.
How do you moderate that?
So that's the thing that I think everyone's scared of. And that's the thing that was actually most difficult for us to get buy-in internally. We are very fortunate that our creative team are in-house, so we're very protective over our brand image and aesthetic. So it goes through various different moderation levels. So Olapik have brand guidelines. They get rid of anything that is, you know, any sort of nudity or rude images, or if there's kind of a competitor logo that's really obvious. It then, all the content comes through to me already tagged with all the products. I then go through a moderation round, and then it goes to our creative team directly, who then approve exactly what goes onto our homepage. In terms of utilising user generated content on our Instagram account, that actually gets approved by our creative director himself.
Wow.
So it's very hands-on to make sure that we kind of identify, okay, this is great for a product page because it's got a commercial push, but does it fit with our brand aesthetic, which is in line with our Instagram strategy, for example?